Look, look at our cities. Look at the people in America, in Europe, in India, in China. Look at humanity. It's dried up.
The human being is the glory of God. You are not manifesting the glory of God. If God is your Father and Jesus manifested the glory of God and you claim Him, but you can't show forth no power. Yet He said, greater works than I do shall you do. And we are doing to what the master did. What happened to us? There's been a disconnect between heaven and earth. And we walk in darkness, and we're without form, and we are void. Look at us. We need a Genesis experience where God steps in and becomes a liberator. So the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. See, and God brought out of water Moses. He was found floating on water, but the water is the people. And when the Spirit of God moves on the people, He raises from the people a leader whom He will enlighten with His glory to reconnect heaven and earth. Well, over in Isaiah, the 65th chapter, 17th verse, he says, for behold, I create new heavens and a new earth, and the former things shall not be remembered nor come into mind. What do you mean, God? You're going to create a new heaven and a new earth? The Honorable Elijah Muhammad said, you know, the sun is dying, so is the moon, so is the stars, so is the earth, and over billions of years, he's gonna create a brand new universe. Behold, Christ says, I make all things new. That means he got power to redo the universe. But he's not talking about that. That's a long way off. He's talking about spiritual and political leadership. A new heaven of spiritual leaders and a new earth of political leaders. Listen to me good now. Brothers and sisters, above the earth, spiritual leaders should be above political leaders. Listen, listen. If spiritual leaders are above the political leaders, then the light from God through the spiritual leaders touches the political leaders, and they bring forth the fruit of good governance. Listen, listen. God sends the prophets into the world. He doesn't send them to bow down to the kings. They respect the kings, they honor the kings, but they're humble to the king, but they always say to the king, thus saith the Lord.
That's why when we were celebrating the homegoing of Mother Rosa Parks, I said to the religious leaders, we've gotten comfortable now, and the world has gone to hell, and we are comfortable. We ride new cars, live in new houses. Talk about us religious leaders. We send our children to nice schools. But the heavens shut up. We're not raining down on Bush. We didn't rain down on Clinton. We didn't shine no light on these darkened minds in high places. These people are the principalities and the powers and the rulers of the darkness of this world and spiritual wickedness that exists in high places. God has shut up the heavens because we have become vassals of the state, because we always need something politicians can give, and then our mouths are shut. So the church becomes the place where we preach, not City Hall, not the State House, not the White House. So the White House has gone to hell. It's been in hell a long time. You just been deceived by Clinton, buddy. Oh man, you suffered worse under him than under others, but you love him. I don't know what is wrong with you. You just a whole bunch of slaves that love a master that haven't done nothing for you. And if he invites us to the White House, we go running.
Guess what? I got me an invitation to say the invocation at the White House. Come to the Senate and say a prayer, then get out.
Makes the thing look good. And you make these beautiful prayers and then get out. Religious people ain't got no business up in here. Get out. Come back to the church and preach, but don't come up in here preaching. So the heavens are shut up and the people are drying up. And darkness has covered the earth. Just look at it.